Hey, Tamara and friends. Well, today I have a story that I'd like to tell you. And this story is a story that's thousands of years old. And in fact, this particular story is what's called a parable. A parable is a story that has a much deeper meaning than just on the surface of the story. And this particular parable is about a man who went on a trip. And when he went on this trip, he ended up being robbed and beaten and left on the roadside for dead. And as he was hurt and injured on the roadside, there came along a man who saw him and saw that he was hurt and injured. And when he saw him, this man decided that he had more important things to do and he really didn't have time to stop and help this gentleman. And so he decided to keep going, even though this man was hurt and injured. Well, then another man came along and saw that this same man had been hurt and injured and was in need of help. And when he saw him, he decided, rather than stop, that he was going to pass to the other side of the road and keep going. And in fact, that's what he did. But then there was this last man. This last man, when he saw the man had been hurt and injured and was laying along the roadside, he felt something inside for this man. He felt sympathy and he felt sorry for the man, and he decided that he could not pass him by, but that in fact he had to stop and help him. So in fact, that's what he did. He stopped and he attended to the man's injuries and he bandaged them up. And he even put the man on his own animal and took him to some place where he could be provided the care that he needed. And this man was even willing to pay for the man's care to make sure that he had exactly what he needed so that he could be made healthy and whole. And so why is that an important story? It's an important story because there are going to be times when we have the opportunity to help somebody, that we're going to have the opportunity to help somebody in need. And that when those opportunities present themselves, they may be people for which we share nothing in common. But nevertheless, there should be something inside of each one of us that makes us feel something for somebody else. That there should be something inside of us that says, if we can stop and do something for somebody else, we can stop and do that because we would want somebody to stop and do that for us. And that's really what kindness is all about, doing for others what you would want somebody to do for you. And so this week and for the years to come, I want us to practice the idea of kindness, doing something for others because it's the right thing to do. And when you stop to share kindness and you're doing something for somebody else that you would want somebody else to do for you, not only is that the golden rule, but that's helping to spread love in a big world. And so until next time, remember, kindness comes from doing unto others as you would have them do unto you. So take care, and I'll see you later.